This is a juicy one, sort of.
Juicy.
Because it's in an Odeon cinema. Now, there's something about... Because cinemas are quite... It's been around for over 100 years, hasn't it? Do you know what I mean? Like, the cinema thing. And like, so you probably find that these old picture houses have got, you know, some creepy things going on. And also...
Mostly in the back row.
Yeah, very true. Some funky things on the back row. But, like, I can't imagine... You know, being on the late shift at a cinema, having to maybe tidy one of the auditoriums by yourself at midnight is that enjoyable. Do you know what I mean? It'd be quite a fucking creepy place, wouldn't it? Well, we've got a message from Rob Angus Colburn, who has emailed in saying a cinema horror. So he says, "Hello, boys. This is my creepiest story from when I worked at an Odeon cinema. Let me know if you want any more. For a bit of background, I'm 22 and started working at my Odeon... By the way, Ben, in the edit, if you could put in some scary music right now, that'd be amazing. All right, some royalty-free scary music. Here we go. For a bit of background, I'm 22 and started working at my Odeon cinema in Exeter, England, May 2015, when I was 17. I like the amount of detail. My cinema had been there since 1939. So as you can expect, lots of things have happened there. There have been many spooky stories surrounding this place, and here is my weirdest one. I was working one night back in February and was checking if the toilets were clean, as that was one of our duties when leaving the gents' toilets. One of my work friends walked from around the corner and attempted to scare me by whispering, "Rob, Rob." This frightened me, as I do get easily jump scared. Once I noticed it was him, I laughed it off, calling him a prick, and we got on with the rest of our shift. Little did I know, I was not the only one to get creeped out by this. A few weeks later, another one of my work friends came out of the same toilets and heard his voice calling, but this time her name, whispering Kim Kim. She was creeped out more than me, as the person whom the voice belonged to, who scared me, was not even at work that day, and was not in until the next night. She later told me about her experience, and it was weird to think that something was imitating his voice. I did some research later that day and found out in some cases ghosts can imitate people's voices that you come into contact with. Once I learned this, I knew that we were being haunted in this building. A few months later, a girl called Emma, who I work with, was in the same area where me and Kim heard this voice again and whispered, "Emma, Emma." Straight away, she came sprinting down to me to the tills where I was working that night. I was also just talking to my manager, Martin, about general things, home life, education, etc. When Emma got to us and told us what she'd heard, our radios and walkie-talkies all started blasting out static, making us jump. Martin, the manager, who does not believe in supernatural and ghosts, etc., thought that there was a rational explanation for this, like we had just intercepted another radio wave. But me and Emma do not think so. A message to take away from this, listeners, is always think twice as to who or what is calling your name. Kind regards, Robert. What do we think of that?
First
then?
Thing I'm thinking is, could it not have been another member of staff who was in contact with the original member of staff who started calling out someone's name?
But it was specifically, it was in detail specifically, it was the same voice.
Yeah, but if
unless you imagine they had like a member of staff that was like an aspiring impressionist.
But if
just like testing his cast.
If you're whispering though, do they not sound similar to each other?
To be fair, I'll give you that. Do people have distinct whispers? Rob.
I mean, if you put an ASMR thing on, I could tell.
Here we have, in the Odeon, Rob. Rob. Martin.
His first. I feel like
what
if
I reckon just David Attenborough got stuck in the toilet.
What if all these people got the same first name and last name?
Yeah. Eve. Kim,
so this was coming through. It's coming through the radio.
No, I think they're cleaning the men's toilets, and then someone's just going, Rob,
every time. Is it always in the toilet?
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Some weird cunt in the cubicle.
There's something dodgy happening in the toilet. It's just probably code for like, gears for a nosh on a knob or something.
Say my name twice if you want a hand
yeah,
job.
Yeah, just not twice, or just say my name twice.
There we go. Well, that's a possible. That's a possible.
That doesn't happen at every.
To be
Odin.
Fair, if I get like, to the toilet in a minute and I'm Dan, I know something's up.
Oh dear, the thing is, like, you may have just like started a trend. Like, you've now started a new
if
code.
If Odin now becomes the place that people could do that safely, I'd go
safely.
Safely.
COVID free. Yeah.
It yeah. used to be phone like phone boxes, but now it's all right, Odin.
And public toilets.
Public toilets.
Oh, yeah. Hand job. What
that's all right, they've got sanitizer now.
Yeah. Away from the sexual connotation, what do you boys think?
I think scarier things could happen at a cinema. I imagine you was just cleaning out the bit where they'll watch the movie and you're in there on your own, and then there's just a guy just sitting at the front. Just
yeah.
Blank. See that?
I was then thinking that.
That yeah. would like...
Imagine that. Yeah, yeah. It's empty. You've gone in there. No one else is in there. You're up the back row just hoovering. You look down, like you say. Midway down, there's just a guy in like a fucking bowler hat.
Yeah, you're like, excuse me.
Oh, he's from like 1940.
Like, excuse me, sir. It's, the film's finished.
Yeah.
It's finished now. And he's just
you finished like, hoovering it, and then yeah. you turn yeah. the hoover
and then
off.
You know when... right, obviously, when you walk, you slightly bobble. Just like he just floats across. Oh, that just reminds me. Sorry, this is such a tangent, but I've got to tell it because it is creepy. My cousin, who shall remain unnamed, he was chatting to this girl for a bit, like Tinder and all the rest of it, invited her around for the obvious reasons, right? And he rang me afterwards. He's like, Geordie, I swear to fucking God, mate, I was fucking terrified. I went and picked up this girl, yeah, drove back, barely any conversation, walked upstairs ahead of her. I fucking shit you not, mate. I looked back at the stairs and she just like floated up the stairs. I was absolutely fucking terrified. I was like, Jesus God, what on earth you brought back there, mate? What on earth you brought back
she
there?
Got a stair lift.
Did he still bang it?
he finished the job. Yeah, but he was floating
around the bedroom.
Yeah, I thought he was just going to say, he was going up the stairs, he turned around.
Booted her back
there.
Down.
Imagine that. There was never any messages.
Imagine that.
Fucking booted her back down.
Mind you, he did do with a few of his mates a Ouija board. he did a Ouija board in the spare bedroom. And I didn't do it, but I can attest for this. That spare bedroom in his now dad's house, it's very fucking cold. It's very weird. And his younger brother... moved into that room for a little bit, would sleep there and that. And his younger brother was never told anything about the Ouija board or anything like that. Nothing, right? Because what would you want to scare a kid? And one night, my cousin, the one who was sleeping in the spare bedroom, ran through to my other cousin's room who did the Ouija board in that room, crying, saying, there was a woman sat at the end of my bed. And when they did the Ouija board in that room, it spelt out Deborah, which I know is a bit of a shit, not a creepy name. But the fact that my younger cousin, Aaron, is his name, he never knew anything about it. Never knew anything. Yeah. And there was like this weird presence in there. And then one night he saw at the end of the bed a woman. Make of that what you will.
Did she say coincidence? Her name was Deborah?
My name's Debbie. Yeah. She's a leg there.
Deborah.
Sorry about that tangent. You just remind me. Well, I reminded myself when I said about the floating person.
I mean,
person.
If her name's Deborah, yeah. I'm imagining like blonde, like cut hair.
Bob.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like a Karen's right-hand woman.
Yeah, Karen's cousin, Deborah.
Yeah. Oh dear. But yeah, now sorry, back to the cinema. I completely agree. That would be absolutely terrifying. And I'd hand him a notice there and then. I wouldn't even do that. I just wouldn't come back, I don't think, if I saw that guy just sat there.
If it was said something a bit scary, if it was just saying his name.
Yeah.
Really, yeah, if it's something just weird out the back after you stop clean, like turn
Hoover
off.
If I ever come into a ghost and he's just like, James, yeah, I'd be like, well done, mate. You know,
Don't wear it out, fucking hell.
Yeah, if it was in there going, I'm going to kill you, I'd be like, fuck that.
Some weirdo in the back. Just like, you finish cleaning, turn the Hoover off, and he just goes, you missed a bit.
and then disappears.
Oh, fuck off, mate. You've been masturbating for 2 days straight.
Oh, God. Oh, dear. Yeah, now, nah, okay, so what would we give that out of 10?
Be nice. I'll give it
on the spook scale.
I'll give it a 5. Let's just go midway.
Okay.
I'll go 5.
Good. Remember, we want him to come back and listen again.
Yep.
Yeah. Take him. It could be our only subscriber.
I don't know.
It could have been a Frogger.
Oh.
Oh.
Just living in the cinema, eating popcorn and the little drink. But I'll go.
To be fair, stick a movie on and that would be a bad idea.
Cinema Frogging.
Free Wi-Fi. I'd go, six.
Six.
Oh, I see, yeah.
Okay, I mean, it's generous. Okay, cool. In the comments, guys, let us know out of 10. I'm going to give it, I'll give it a 6 as well. So I think that brings it up to 5.5 out of 10. So Robert, try harder next time, son, all right?